Hello everybody, it's Dreamy Mind here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. With the current event See You Tomorrow, we are once again getting another welfare magical girl, Seika Kumi. I will go over her stats to connect Magia and Team and my money recommendations. Seika is a water magical girl and as a 4-star she has a max HP of 20,925, a max attack of 5,787 and a max defense of 5,546. Compared to the other 4-star water magical girls, her HP is average and high when compared to the other 4-stars. Her attack is average when compared to the other 4-star water magical girls and low when compared to the other 4-stars. Finally, her defense is low when compared to both the 4-star water magical girls and the other 4-stars in general. She is a support type and her growth and leveling is focused towards her attack and HP. When taking a look at her discs, we can see that she has one charge disc, one vertical and one horizontal blast disc, and two XL discs. Her MP gain is quite good. From a XL charge XL combination, you can earn around 45 MP. Let's move on to her Connect and Magia. Seika's Connect is called depending on her rarity, she increases the attack of the targeted ally between 27.5% and 37.5%. She also increases their damage done by charged discs between 15% and 25%. Finally, she also grants them a 60 to 100% chance to fuck the enemy. Her Magia Tidal Wave deals damage to all enemies. As a 2-star, she deals damage between 300 and 340%. As a 3-star, between 320 and 360%. And as a 4-star, between 340 and 380%. This depends on her Magia level. As a 2-star, she also has a 47.5% to fuck the enemy for 3 turns. When being a 3-star and above, the fog becomes guaranteed. Finally, only as a 4-star, she also decreases the enemy's damage done by blast discs for 3 turns between 25 and 35%, once again depending on Magia level. Due to her highest rarity, being a 4-star, Seika doesn't have a double yet. But this might probably will happen in the future when we will be able to awaken her to the 5-star rarity. Considering that we already got two water welfare magical girls, namely Umika and Melissa, Seika has a lot to live up to, but luckily she is much different from those two. First of all, she has great discs. She has 2 blast discs, so she can reach a good amount of the field, but due to her low attack stat, she sadly has a hard time functioning in a blast team. Her disc distribution seems to profit her MP gain the best. She can fill her MP bar without too much trouble and as a AoE Magia, so she can quickly use her Magia over and over again. This does make up a little bit for her weak attack stat. Seika is a support type, but she is not a healer and focuses on the other side of supporting. Her Connect has 3 buffs, but some may be a little bit inconsistent. She increases the damage done by charged discs for a decent amount. Sadly, the charge meta isn't that strong, but that doesn't mean it can't help out. Anyway, if the charge buff isn't of use for you during that turn, then don't worry. She will also grant the targeted ally a attack buff, considering that Seika can only be maxed to a 4-star. The 37.5% attack boost is a decent amount. A 5-star Alina has the same attack buff, which always helps out, and so does Seika's attack buff. As a 2-star, she gives the targeted ally a 60% chance to put the fog debuff on the attacked enemies. However, you shouldn't use her as a 2-star. It would be much better to use her as a 3-star. And as a 4-star Seika is even better, of course. By then, the attacked enemies will surely be suffering from that fuck debuff. Do note that the fuck debuff only gives the enemy a 25% chance to miss their attack, so it isn't great. But if you're lucky, they will miss. Her Magia has the same fuck debuff, and a nice add is the 3-turn blast damage decrease debuff on the enemies. Especially when you're playing with 5 magical girls on your field, blast damage can be a real pain, but Seika will soften the pain for you. Sadly, Seika's stats are really bad. Everything is mostly average to low. We are lucky that she is a welfare magical girl, so I suggest getting her destiny gems so you can at least have a 4-star memoria slots for her to help her improve her stats. It won't make her the best, but it certainly will make her better. The same counts for getting her Magia upgrade items, since she relies on her Magia the most to do good damage. It will certainly help you out if you would have her at Magia level 5. However, I don't advise using her in PvP. Her stats are really too bad for that. She can do decent damage and using her Magia is her strength. But due to her horrible defense, she won't stay alive to get her Magia bar 200. She probably won't even survive long enough to perform a connect. Now let's move on to team recommendations. Since Seika gives support to charge teams, she can fit in a charge team with, for example, Ayame, Mayui and Momoko. Naturally, Seika can support them with her connect, which will increase both their charge damage and gives them a attack buff. Her discs, however, don't really fit in a charge team, but it will give you some versatility to make other combos besides charge combos. Ayame was a welfare as well, and if you don't have her, don't worry, she will probably come back. Anyway, with both her connect and Magia, Ayame can inflict the burn debuff on the enemies to make sure they go down easier. She also buffs the whole team's attack stat after performing her Magia for 3 turns, so that is something that can definitely help Seika. Mayu really helps Seika with her durability and attack. Her connect will let Seika evade enemy attacks and will give her at max a 60% chance to land a critical hit. Momoko also helps Seika's damage outboost. With her connect, she can give Seika a attack boost and will let her ignore the enemy's defense when she attacks them. Besides that, her Magia also buffs the team's blast damage for 3 turns and Seika can profit from this nicely. Due to Seika's reliance on her Magia to deal the most damage, she also fits in a Magia spamming team with Elena, Lika and Melissa. All 3 of them can increase MP gain from Excel discs. Reyna and Rika can increase damage output since their connect offers a chance to land a critical hit. Seika can mainly help her allies out with her own attack boost, and sometimes the fuck debuff can come in handy as well. Anyway, the most important with this team is of course to use your Magia as often as possible. Furthermore, you can combine Seika with anyone who has 2 charge discs to profit enough from her connect. So you can put Seika together with Mami, for example. Mami has 2 charge discs, so Seika can help by increasing her damage output even more, while Mami's connect can bind enemies for 1 turn, protecting both magical girls from enemy attacks for 1 turn. Mami and Seika both have good MP gain, so they shouldn't have any trouble building up their Magias. Besides that, Mami has a skill quicken buff on her Magia, and since Seika will use active Memorias, it can help her by reducing the cooldown, which allows her to use her active Memorias faster. However, mummy has this skill only in the English version, so this doesn't apply to JP. Sega's personal memoria, an obsessive secret collection, gives her upon activation a attribute draw, meaning you will only get the discs of Sega's attribute. Therefore, you will only get discs of water magical girls. This can be useful, for example, when Sega is the only water magical girl on your team, or when you're up against enemies which both have fire and another attribute in it and you need water discs. So feel free to use it. It can be a good memoria in certain situations. Other good memorias for Sega are, for example, those days are gone and walking the same path. They will heal Sega's HP slightly, so it increases her durability a little bit. They also each have a secondary effect. Those days are gone will increase her magia damage, and walking the same path will give her a general damage boost. The damage boost will work on all attacks including her magia, so it is the better memoria out of the two. But in case you don't have it, those days are gone is also good. If you want to increase Sega's MP gain, use It's Not Like I Was Waiting or The Flavor of Drama. The Flavor of Drama is especially recommendable if you put Sega in a fight with both fire and forest enemies, because this memoria also increases the MP gain when getting hit by the element one is weak against, in Sega's case, forest of course. If you're looking for some active memorias to use, Past and Future and Splash Party are good options. They will increase Sega's damage output. This includes her discs and her magia, while also giving her a defense cut. So it is good for both offense and defense. Past and Future will give the buffs for 3 turns, and Splash Party is the 3-star alternative memoria. The buffs are slightly stronger, but at the cost of having it active for only 1 turn. Finally, if you are worried about her durability in battle, you can use For the Ones I Love. Upon activation, this memoria will give Sega a 3-turn damage cut, which can be up to 20%, and it will also regenerate her HP slightly. Overall, Sega is a water magical girl who relies mostly on her magia to deal decent damage. Since she is a welfare, we can easily get her magia level to level 5. She is also great as a supporter for charge-oriented magical girls, but other than that, she herself is quite weak. Still, I recommend getting her and everything you need to awaken her and increase her magia level from the event shop. So, what do you think about Sega, and are you liking the event so far? Feel free to let me know down in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you did. You can also follow me on Twitter, link is in the description below, as well as my magia record player IDs if you wish to follow me. Have a good morning, afternoon, night, or whatever your time zone is, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye!